Good morning from snowy Spitzingsee. It's 5 o'clock in the morning, and I'm ready to start my hike towards Rotwandhaus. Then from there, I'm going to walk over to a lake called Soinsee. Overall, the overall hike is 3 hours. So I'm going to be there at around 8, I hope. And with some luck, it's going to be a nice day for photographs. Talk to you a bit later. This is as far as I made it until sunrise. It's around 7 o'clock now, and I'm at around 1,700 meters. And I don't want to miss this opportunity for a photograph with the rising sun, or maybe a couple photographs. So I have a nice composition over there. So this is the composition, you can see it on the video right now. I want to have the rock in the foreground and these nice trees here, and then the sea of mist and the mountain peaks. And I don't know if now is the right time I will take a photograph, and I will wait a bit longer. There is also a very nice composition over there. I will turn the camera to show it to you. This area I like very much, but not from exactly this vantage point that we are now. I need to go a bit further to the left for that one. And then there's another one over there, but I need to be further down for that one. So for now, this spot, this composition. Okay, second photo of the day, and I'm thinking in that direction. So let's have a look. With all these rocks in the foreground, down here, and the mist in the background, and the beautiful mountains across. Now I have to get low, I think, somewhere here. Okay, I've chosen my spot now, down here. That area is getting nicer as well. But let's take this photo first. I don't know if I have to focus stack for this one, but with and focal length of 18 millimeters, I don't think so. I'm focusing on the rock here, and I expect the whole photograph will be sharp. I ended up focus stacking and bracketing. So it took around 4 or 5 shots. Somewhere between those, there will be a good one. I'm gonna go over there, down there, and take another photograph of those peaks over there with the pink clouds at the top. It should be nice. So the sun came out now and it really transformed again the landscape as usual. I took a vertical composition with these rocks here in the foreground and everything else in the background. So I'll show you in the video for a minute. So here it is, the rocks in the foreground, the sunny hill in the middle ground, and the mist and the mountains in the background. And now I'm going to do something that I heard about in a I saw that in a YouTube video, and it's called focal length stacking. I haven't tried it before. The idea is you use a very open, wide focal length to photograph the foreground, and then you zoom in, you lift the lens, the camera a bit, and you photograph the mountains in the background. So let's go ahead and try it out. I'm gonna try it with a landscape composition in this case. So it's gonna be like this. Moving down first with the wide focal length, focusing on the rock in front of me and taking the photograph. And then I'll focus on these rocks as well. I'm not sure how many actual photographs I have to take for this, because it's the first time I try it out, but let's see. So now I'll move it up. There. And take another photograph with this focal length for the middle ground. So now I'm taking a second photograph for the middle ground there, and now I'm going to move it up a bit more there, and I'm going to zoom in so that the mountains are bigger. I'm not sure this is going to work, but what do I have to lose? Nothing. Focusing on the mountains and taking the shots. And my hands are freezing, and my body is freezing because I was sweaty from coming up here, and now that I stopped, but it's good that I brought a second layer of clothes, so I'm gonna change clothes now. Here are the two versions of the image side by side for comparison, on the left without zooming in, on the right having zoomed in at 24 mm. The blend happens in the cloud area, below that the two photographs are identical. And here we have the vertical composition I took a bit earlier for comparison. That one was taken at 28 mm. It would be interesting to see if it would be better to have taken a vertical panorama at 28 mm at landscape mode. Sunrise over the mountain, and somebody is hunting deer probably on the other side of the mountain, probably behind this mountain ridge in front of you now, because I can hear shots. I don't know where exactly they're coming from, but it's not too far away. They're very loud. I can't say that I liked the hike in the dark 2 hours, but getting up here at this time of the day was worth it, I think, because you don't get these views if you come later. The mist isn't there anymore, the light isn't as soft, so I mean, look at that. The So I'm here, this is Rotwandhaus. This is the highest point that I'm going to reach today. And then now I need to walk another 45 minutes downhill to reach the lake. But here I have two photograph opportunities. One is over there. To the right of this slope with a very long lens so that I keep the sun out of the frame. There are some nice fog in the ridges over there. And the other one is that one which I've been seeing for some time now, and I don't know exactly what is the best way to photograph it. Again with a long lens, I don't know, maybe I'll try to put this fence in the frame, which is nice. Let's see. I looked around at both sides, there and there. That side, it's impossible to take a photograph now directly against the sun. It's too strong, so even if it's not, the sun is not in the frame, the glare is so strong that I have no detail at all in the photograph. So I'm going to take a photograph of this area over there, which I've been looking at since it became daylight and I could see it. And I think now there is a window of opportunity for another half an hour maybe to photograph it, because the sun came up with a vengeance. It's a really bright day and the light isn't as nice anymore. So this may be the last photograph I'm making today. I'll walk to the lake to see it, because I came all this way. It's another hour to the lake, but I'm not very optimistic regarding photographs. So let's take this one and see. I'm going to include the fence in front of me in the frame and very little sky. I want the fence and I want that peak on the right in the frame, and just a few of the peaks on the left, and mainly this corridor of mist among the various mountains. That's fine, I think.
Okay, so I don't think this photograph was anything to write home about or any kind of a portfolio image. The light was already too hard for that, but I thought it was worth sharing just for the very beautiful view.
Look at this cat. I don't know where it came from. Up here, it's on its own. I honestly haven't seen a fatter cat in my life. So there must be a lot to eat up here. Probably belongs to the people in the hut here. So I think that is the lake there in front of us. I will zoom in a bit to show you better. I think that must be the lake, and it seems to be frozen, which is not unusual this time of the year up here. This is a very small lake, probably shallow, but I honestly expected that it wouldn't be frozen yet because we didn't have so many cold days, but who knows. okay, back to Rotwandhaus now. I didn't go all the way to the lake because it was frozen, so it didn't make much sense to walk for another hour since the view wasn't, there wouldn't be any good photograph opportunities. So now I'm gonna head back down, which is that way, and be there in about 2 hours. Okay guys, this is it for today. I'm heading back now. I took all the photographs I could take. It's still wonderful up here, but not for the photographer anymore. I enjoyed the walk very much. Not the part in the dark the first 2 hours, but after that it was really great. I didn't make it all the way to Soinsee, but it was frozen anyway, so I don't think it was worth it. So this is a rain check for spring now, when the ice melts. So I hope in about an hour and a half I'll be in the car, and then by noon at home. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to click that like button and to subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. See you next week. Bye bye.